Today we're going to talk about keyword research, and I'm going to show you a few free tools that will help you both generate keyword ideas and then make sure that those keyword ideas are the best ones for your website. At Volusion, we use a whole set of tools. One that we use very, very frequently is Google AdWords. So the account I've logged into here is just a free account. Anybody can set one up. So let's go back to the vintage belt example from last time. I'm just gonna start populating this with a couple different keywords. So once I've seeded it with a few keyword ideas, I'm gonna go ahead and click Get Ideas. This is gonna do two things for me. First of all, it's gonna generate a list of keyword ideas. And the other thing it's gonna do is show me the search volume. There might be a keyword that I had not thought about that has a better search volume than one of the keywords I chose. The average monthly searches for affordable vintage belts and buy vintage belts online are actually pretty negligible. So I'm going to want to be searching for keywords that have a higher search volume than that. These leather keywords are pretty good. Western is great and not something I had originally thought about, but vintage Western belts could be a great keyword for my site. You can also go to add group ideas, and this will just kind of group your keyword ideas by topic. So see, we've got fashion belts, ladies belts, all kinds of different keyword kind of buckets, and within those you've got a whole new list of keywords that you can choose from. You take a look over here at competition and suggested bid. Those can kind of be important guidelines to consider, but we usually ignore them because that's more for the PPC side of things. You might not want to, you know, bid on a keyword that's $30 per click or whatever, which would be insane. But you could try to incorporate it into your SEO strategy so that you can rank for that keyword for free. Another site that I really like using is called UberSuggest. It's sort of like Google's autocomplete function on steroids. So UberSuggest pulls all the different autocompletes for a certain word or search term. So let's try vintage belts, just see what happens. I'm gonna hit suggest. Here's our full list, and it goes alphabetically. It'll give you some really, really popular keywords at the top, and then it'll take you more granularly into the autocomplete. So we've got vintage belts and buckles, we've got vintage army belts, vintage Armani belts, and that's all just for the letter A. It takes us all the way down through all of these different letters. What's great about this tool is that there are so very many keyword ideas that it'll give you, and you know that this is based on actual searches. So I love using this tool for keyword searches as well, particularly as I get more and more what's called long tail, which means keywords that are less broad, but more targeted. So there might be a keyword with only a search volume of 10, like let's say vintage garter belts and stockings might have a really low search volume, but if I sell those, chances are the person or people who are searching for that, like that's exactly what they want. And then the other basic way to do keyword research, just to not ignore the obvious here, is to actually Google your search term. Let's say that affordable leather belts was a good keyword. You can see that the people ranking at the top for these are all fairly big, well-known companies. We've got Overstock.com, we've got Old Navy, we've got Amazon. None of that's great. Number one is Belt Outlet, which could possibly be a smaller shop, but it's so specialized, so that's gonna be really hard to outcompete. Once we get down to the fifth result or so, things get a little bit less competitive. You know, it's not the worst idea to hang on to that keyword and try to rank for it, because you could get a little bit lower on the page, but you have to approach it with the understanding that we will probably not be number one for that keyword. What I'm really looking for would be competitors that are similar to my shop size, preferably people with a not so great SEO, because then I can outrank them really easily. So that was an overview on how to find the right keywords for your website. Make sure to tune in next time so that we can talk about how to choose the right content strategy for your website.